Dr. Jennifer Ashton, what a parent should do with the information.
Any parent wants to keep his or her child as safe as possible. What's in the past is in the past. And if your child is healthy and is being seen regularly by his or her pediatrician and is following all developmental milestones and is not manifesting any signs of possible systemic or overall illness,
if you can't eat it, you probably don't want to rub it on your skin. But she also says that it doesn't appear that the amounts of these chemicals are harmful.
You know, the drugstore chain CVS is supposedly already checking out some of these products. What are the other stores saying?
Well, the the Trade Association, the Personal Care Products Council, the National Association, calls this report incomplete and alarmist. And one of the biggest companies, Johnson & Johnson, they tell us, we are disappointed that the campaign for safe cosmetics has inaccurately characterized the safety of our products, misrepresented the overwhelming consensus of scientists and government agencies that review the safety of ingredients, and unnecessarily alarmed parents. Companies also point out some chemicals are there to keep the products free of bacteria. Chef, if you have all natural shampoo and all it's made up of is aloe and honey and jojoba oil, you can have a bottle of mold at the end of the week.
Yeah, that makes sense. You know, the campaign for safe cosmetics. Who's the campaign for safe cosmetics? I've never heard of it.
Well, it's a San Francisco-based national nonprofit group. It's a coalition, really. It's made up of various public health, labor, environmental, and consumer rights groups. And according to their website, all of their funding comes from the